So this is going to be about John B. Stetson. This man means a lot to me. And he's truly the hatter that shaped American culture in the making of the cowboy hat. The cowboy hat has basically been the same for about 150 years now. And it's still served the purpose for many people very well. But we know what the cowboy hat looks like. But do you know really what its roots are, what it came from? And that was from a man named John B. Stetson. Stetsons have long been associated with cowboys, but their function is very important to understanding the life of cowboys. A lot of quote-unquote cowboys were farmers or prospectors that were just normal people back in the 1800s. And you had several different parts of a hat. You had the crown, which is what your head set in, and there would be what's called a cowboy crease, and it would give you different types of ways it would set on your head and how comfortable it would be, things like that. And then you had the brim, which would protect you from the sun, and they were waterproof because they were made of felt, and so it would protect you from the rain and snow, things like that. And then there was bands, but those were more for just to set your Stetson apart from everybody else's. Mr. Stetson made the design from two different ideas. One was from a normal coonskin cap because it was waterproof, and then he took the Mexicans' ideas with the sombrero to protect you from the sun and making the brim. Hat makers at the time had a horrible reputation. They would use gases and mercury and things like that to cure out the felt. And a lot of times they would ingest it or breathe it, and it would totally make them go haywire. And so they was really bad looked upon. That's where the term Mad Hatter from Alice in Wonderland came from. But John B. Stetson was a Christian, and he had a Puritan work ethic. And he wanted to set apart hatters for the time and give them a better name. But during the process of all his ideas, he was permanently diagnosed with tuberculosis at about age 15, which was a horrible thing at the time because there was no cure. And so he lived in Pennsylvania, and big city, and so he moved to Colorado to become a prospector and try and strike it rich with gold, but that worked out horribly for him. But even with his illness and now prospecting not working out, he became what his dad taught him to be, a hatter, working for prospectors and local farmers in the Colorado area. And Mr. Stetson incorporated his new ideas in such a different way that it caught everybody off guard about why the hats looked the way they did, but they found them so useful that everybody wanted a Stetson. I mean, he couldn't hardly keep making them in order to meet the demand. And he started out just with $100 to his name in a little bitty apartment, and he used a lot of that money on tools and $10 worth of felt. And that's how it started. But as the business began to grow, he began to get different things, and he started making luxury hats. One of them even cost $10, which at the time was about a month's pay for the average person. And so things just kept building and building and building, and eventually he decided to move back to Philadelphia to start a factory and start doing things a lot differently than what people expected. See, with the factory, it eventually grew to be over 6 acres of land. It included its own hospital, its own fire department, its own police department. And Mr. Stetson was known for his very large amounts of pay. People were paid very, very handsomely for the time. But he was extremely strict, which was a lot of people's disclaimer with Mr. Stetson, because he just really stressed cleanliness and organization to the point where it was almost annoying for most people. But it caused his factory to run at tip-top shape, and he never seen a low period until after his death. Mr. Stetson eventually grew to having over 1,500 people that he employed, and they would have such benefits that had never been seen before. Also, he incorporated traveling salesmen that had never been seen in the hat industry before, and that's truly what led to basically every American wearing a Stetson hat. So, now that we've talked a little bit about Mr. Stetson, I hope you learned about his early business life and how that his terminal illness didn't stop him from achieving his dreams. And that he really did change the way that hatters were looked at. They were now looked at somebody who was organized and clean and kept things growing. And also, Stetsons in his hats still now, like I said, for 150 years have proven themselves over time. And so next time you see a Stetson hat, don't just think about it's a cowboy hat. Think about the legacy that's come with it. Thank you.